There used to be a time in the body, there used to be a time when we came to church that the leaders, the intercessors, had to do warfare with the believers. Now, everybody's an elder. Come on, y'all get on Facebook. Now everybody's a prophet. Everybody's a minister. I'm about to climb this hill. I'm about to really hit it deep right here. I mean, I'm about to make the devil mad. Because now everybody's an apostle. No work. But they got titles. And the funny thing is, Jesus said this. He said, I give gifts unto men, but you got a title. You got a title with no gifting. I'm making the devil mad. God, thank you. The sad truth is, because the intercessors now have to fight intercessors. The elders got to now fight elders. The evangelists got to fight the evangelists. Now we leave all the burden on the pastors. And the pastors not only have to preach and deliver a word, but now they got to pump and prime the service. They got to come in and fix the atmosphere because of what you put in yourself. And we wonder why so many of our leadership is dying early. We're going to help them out. I'm trying to help somebody. I know I'm moving slower than what you wanted me to. I submit to you, believers. I submit to you that there's an obvious problem with what we call church. And the remnant feel it. The remnant sit in their seats and we say, what's going on? She said, something's not right. You hear some people say some testimonies and your Holy Ghost liar meter goes up. La 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 la. Y'all ain't got that liar meter? Y'all need to get it. It'll keep you. You hear some people preaching and you say, that's not God. You see some people laying hands and you say, God, that's not God. And I'm not talking about those folks who sit back and say, oh no, that don't agree with my spirit. No, no, no. It didn't have to agree with it. Hold on, let me say this right. I'm not talking about the folks that say that didn't agree with my spirit because you really deserve it out of your flesh. Because you didn't like it, now you said it. I'm talking about the folks who ain't got to say nothing. They just sit back in their seat and they say, God, we need your glory. God, Jesus, God. Oh, God, come in the room. God, come in the room. Now, God, fill them. Give them the Holy Ghost for real. I'm talking about the folks that ain't got to come up in front of the altar and intercede. I'm talking about the folks that sit in the seat, that are sitting in the back of the church, and say, God. The folks that just shout the name of Jesus and you'll feel faith in the atmosphere. That's what I'm talking about. The remnant, they feel it. They feel it. They're saying something's wrong.
Glory.
So today I want to address two questions. I want to address the questions, how did we get here and where do we go from here?
All right.
How did we get here and where do we go from here? So in fact, how did we get here, beloved? I suggest to you that sin is in the camp. Somehow, some way, sin has crept into our churches and into our homes and worse, into our hearts. The question we must ask is, who let it in? Because anytime something has entered, then either it is broken in or it's been invited or allowed in. And if it were a break in, then there would be evidence, but something would be broken or shattered. But I stand as a detective tonight in the spirit realm. I see sin, but I see no evidence of a break in. Because we're still going to church, and we're still singing, and we're still shouting, and we're still dancing. But there's conclusive evidence that sin is in our hearts. Because sin, it's got to be in the heart. And the body of Christ has become a mummy. The body of Christ has become a dead man walking. Because there's no life in us. We're just walking, we're walking, we're going alone, and we're passing by those people on the streets, and your brothers and your sisters who you know are not saved. There's no life in us, but we're still walking. And because we can come in here and shout, and we can come in here and sing, and we get a fleshly gratification for something that should be spiritual. And we leave and we say we had church. Body of Christ has become a dead man walking. And understand this. We were born with a sinful nature, but we're not born sinners. Look to your neighbor and say, holiness is still right. Many preachers preach that we were born in sin. But David said in Psalm 51 verse 6 that I was born in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. And this is a personal testimony. But my testimony today is, I was born in, with a sinful nature. He that is in Christ is a new creature. All things are passed away, and behold, all things are made new. Tell your neighbor, that's why I know my now harvest is about to hit. Because all things are made new. Tell your neighbor, that's why I know I'm about to find a new car. Because all things are made new. Yeah. I had a little money when I wasn't saved, but when I joined on the God side, when I accepted Christ as my Savior, I got an inheritance from the Heavenly Father. And the Bible declares that my Father is a rich and powerful man. Stop your neighbor and high five and say new and better. Stop the other neighbor and say new and better. Now switch it around and say better and new, better and new, better and new, better and new. It's coming for me, it's coming. Better and new, better and new. Better and new. That's my testimony. Maybe I'm just preaching to myself. Sin is the problem. Sin has caused a fall. Into the hearts of the believers. But here's the thing, most of us don't even realize it. When sin enters into the heart, watch this, it corrupts or perverts the heart. In other words, it deceives the heart. And before you know it, sin will cause your heart to call right wrong and wrong right. This is why the Bible says that the heart is deceitful and desperately wicked above all things. Because God knew that sin would enter into the heart of men. And the Bible says that God looked over into Satan and saw iniquity. So anything that is corrupt is no longer useful in the kingdom of God. Hence the reason David was kicked out of heaven. And this is the hour that God says, I'm not looking for your heart. Your heart is deceitful. Your heart is nasty. But he said, I'm looking for my heart on the inside of you. God is looking for people that look like him. Furthermore, God is looking for people that sound like him. Y'all got to talk to me. Hear the Bible.